by listening to your smartphone's Wi-Fi address or MAC address. It's anonymous, it doesn't know that it's you or me, it just knows that a unique individual is there. This is Rob. Rob owns a cafe, and we recently shipped one of these devices to him. And using the Density application, it was easy for him to get started. Plug it into an outlet. He gave the device an internet connection, or a Wi-Fi connection, and it immediately counted the number of people in his venue. Now, it's real-time count at the top. You can see beneath that a bunch of locked data and statistics or graphs. We do that for two reasons. One, because seeing zeros and flat graphs on day one sucks. And two, because it's our method of re-engagement. So as time passes, 10 days, 30 days, 60 days, Density collects enough information to notify him that we have relevant data for him. When he goes back into his dashboard and sees new information, like visitor count this week, average visitor duration spent per day, how many people uniques he's getting per month, and even new versus loyal. So the next time he sponsors a bi-local dinner, he can see a surge or a spike in new customers coming to his business. This is data that Rob has never had before, and he's certainly not had it in his mobile device. Now, he actually owns three different cafes across the same city, so while he's out picking up his nephew from soccer practice, he can still track of the foot traffic to each of these vendors. Density is a device. Density is a mobile application. But what is remarkable about Density is its network. So with it installed in many other businesses in the same city, in Rob's city, he can see information that he's never been able to see before in relation to other businesses, who he shares customers with, where foot traffic is trending, where loyal customers also love to go. Now, Rob's actually trying to improve his wholesale boom business, so he goes up to the top, you share customers with, clicks number one, which is a grocery store called Grassroots, and can see that greater than 30% of the customers that shop at his cafe also shop at this grocery. But they don't carry his beans, they don't carry his coffee. So he reaches out to the owner, Abigail, and he says, I'm reasonably confident that you'll be able to move my coffee. Density has given Rob all the data that he needs to be a better business. And in effect, Density is unearthing a network that already exists, a network that you and I are part of. So the next time you're in a crowded bar, look up. It's all lost data, simply because no one was listening. Thank you.
Get to the density of retail.
Yeah, I mean, if you're in a half-mile radius, you're questions here. One, so get the value of the shopkeeper or any different business, but what's the value of the consumer? Because I imagine things like, let's go to the gym, and I don't have to show up, let's fuck the pet, go to downtown, or how many girls are actually at this club? Which relates to my second question, are you profiling people, even though it's anonymous, if you look at where they're coming from, whether they came from a girls' sport or this club, you can start to understand age and demographics of that basket. So what's the value of the consumer and how are you profiling people?
Yeah, we're not trying to really go after profiling just yet, mostly because we're not entirely sure how people react to privacy concerns. So it's really important to get to a point where people are comfortable leaving their Wi-Fi on and wandering through the local network. One, and then two, you were asking about
what's the value of the consumer?
Well, eventually, once it's installed, it's for the larger scale.
Or you might actually build an interface for consumer.
I mean,